And if it was an energy policy, it would include energy security so that Canadians knew that there was, if we're an energy superpower, we're at least looking after our own needs before we ship it somewhere else. The other piece that's really missing in all this, of course, is, is the jobs issue. Why do you suppose all the unions in Northern Alberta are opposed to the Keystone Pipeline? 2008 financial crisis. Up until the 2008 financial crisis, there were operators planned for Alberta. During the financial crisis, all of the investment that was planned for Northern Alberta sort of went on hold on the shelf for a while. And then after the financial crisis sort of receded, things like Shell, Jackpine Mine, Phase 2 came back, whole bunch of proposals for expanded projects came back, investors from the People's Republic of China showed up, buying up oil sands operations. The one thing that didn't come back was the upgraders. Instead, we had Keystone XL, and a proposal that we are not going to upgrade from solid bitumen to synthetic crude in Northern Alberta, which is frankly quite a lot of jobs. We're going to put it in a pipe and send it down to the Gulf of Mexico coast, where there are both refineries that were built for Venezuelan bitumen, heavy crude bitumen from Venezuela, so they could handle it, and also, of course, a deep water port to stick it in tankers to send it elsewhere, which is really what this is about, shipping it out to other refineries, not even in North America. Now, having told you bitumen is a solid, you're probably wondering what they plan to do to make it run in a pipe. So this is something that I think gets explained. I'm really sorry, I hope this isn't really what you didn't want, you want to hear, bitumen and pipelines and tankers, and why I'm not just ranting about how bad it is.